हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे आई स्टार्ट माय वीडियो विद द बेसिस ऑफ अकाउंटिंग सब्जेक्ट। दिस वीडियो इज़ रिलेटेड टू द बेसिक कंसेप्ट्स ऑफ अकाउंट सब्जेक्ट और मीनिंग ऑफ अकाउंट सब्जेक्ट। एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू प्लस वन सिलेबस अकाउंट्स हैज़ नाइन अकाउंट सब्जेक्ट हैज़ नाइन यूनिट्स एंड हैज़ थ्री पार्ट्स। फर्स्ट पार्ट इज़ कंपल्सरी फॉर ऑल एंड ए पार्ट इज़ कंपल्सरी फॉर ऑल, बी और सी हैज़ ऑप्शन and we will done the B part. So according to your exam, A part or B part are done by ourselves or C is not done in PSEB syllabus. So what is accounts? Basically, first of all, we know about the meaning of our subject. Accounts, as we know, is in a language of finance, as accounts is related to a financial transaction. So accounting is basically done for recording the basic financial transactions that are related to our business or banks or any other institutions. So the father of accounting, the person who gives the subject of accounting is named Luca Pacioli. So accounting is in a wider version of bookkeeping, as the name suggests. Bookkeeping means recording the transaction in the book. Bookkeeping means maintaining something in the books. So bookkeeping, recording the certain financial transaction related to our business, are recorded in one books. For example, we make the notes of our plus one class, so it's maintaining the book. So this book is helpful in our test or in our exams, so it is type of bookkeeping. So bookkeeping has the greater version, that is called accounting. Next, briefly explain the meaning of accounting. It is an art of recording, classifying, summarizing in proper manner the terms of money transaction related to financial nature. So accounting is basically done for recording the transaction. Classifying means distributing the transaction under different heads. Summarizing means totaling of these transaction in proper manner or in sequence, like date wise, chronological order, or in the terms of money. So as we know, the account is related to financial transactions, so transaction only related to money are recorded under accounting. Transaction are related to the financial nature, as same, these are related to money or money worth. So the meaning explaining by this, these following steps are followed for completing the meaning of accounting. Firstly, we collect the information like I'll explain it with an example. Collecting information, then this information is recording at a particular place, then classifying this information. Classifying means distributing the information under different heads, under different parts. Then summarizing the information means totaling of information. Analyzing the transaction, properly analyzing, briefly explaining the transaction, then interpreting it, and then communicating. Communicating means those information is helpful to the different type of persons like banks, government. So this information, recording of this information is helpful to those parties who are willing to understanding the accounting transactions of our business. So it's a part of communication. Let's take an example. If one person sell goods to Ram for 20,000. So firstly, we collect this information. This information is like sold goods to Ram for 20,000. So this is in a part of information. This is helpful for us. Then we recording the information. This information is recording as the in a form of entries that you should understood in the part numerical viewpoints. Next, we recording the information. Recording information like Ram's account or in goods account. So next, classifying, then this information is classifying under different heads, like first is Ram account, next is goods account. Next, summarizing, then totaling of this account, RAM accounts total or goods accounts total. Then analyzing मतलब briefly discussing or briefly viewing these transactions. Then interpreting these transaction, interpreting briefly explaining these transaction in your viewpoint. So every those persons who are not related to commerce easily understand the meaning of this transaction. Next, then communicating the transaction. So if we record the transaction in proper manner, date wise, so this would be helpful for the person who wants our information for future references. So it is communicating. So it is all about our accounting. Accounting has three terms. First is accountancy, accountant, or accounting. Accountancy means a profession, like other profession, lawyer, doctor. So accountancy is a profession like other professions. It is a discipline in which rules and regulations are followed for recording the various transactions. Next is accountant. Accountant is a professional person. The person who done the accounting transactions, recording the accounting transaction, is become an accountant. Next is accounting. Accounting means the method for maintaining the accounts. There are the different methods, different ways, rules or regulation. So accounting is a part of this. Though methods, those are helpful for maintaining the various different accounts, various accounts. So it is called accounting. So for proper understanding of accounting or its meaning, its importance, firstly we should discuss about the basic terms. Those are used in account to time, in every case, in every line or in every transaction. So first basic term that we should study is business transaction. As the name suggests, business transaction. Transaction means any exchange between the two persons or more than two persons, any exchange of things, any exchange of ideas, this is called transaction. So business transaction is only in financial nature. Any exchange of goods between the two persons, exchange of goods and services for money, for cash or for credit with any person is called business transaction. Business transaction is only termed in the financial nature. So for cash or for credit, for example, A sold goods to B 20,000. So there is a business transaction between A and B, or amount included in this transaction is 20,000. If the person pays the money as soon as the transaction is done, so this is cash transaction. If immediately paid the cash, it's cash transaction. If we promise to pay the amount after some time, for example, after 3 months, after 4 months, after 5 months, then it's a credit transaction. So there is no cash transaction immediately, so it become a credit transaction. So for understanding the business transaction, following point considers. First point is economic activity. As we know, the business transaction is related to finance. So economic activity, as the name economic suggests, the wealth. It is related to our wealth or money terms. Economic activity, every business transaction is done for some profit motive. If we sold goods, we purchased goods, there is some motive in this. If we sold goods for 20,000, then there is an economic activity. Every person sold goods in business for making our profits, gains. So it is an economic activity, activity related to gaining the profit, gaining some benefit. It's called economic activity. So business transaction done for maintaining its economic activity. Next, B point, external or internal. Every business transaction must be external or internal. Internal, the transaction, those are done within the organization, or internal transaction. The transaction, those are done outside the business, it's called external transaction. Internal transaction, for example, if the two employees of the business, if any two persons of the business exchange the goods between with each other, so it's called internal transaction. If you sold the goods outside the party, the person who is not related to your business is become your external transaction. Third one is quantitative and qualitative. So every transaction has quantitative aspect as well as qualitative aspect. Quantitative aspect, if the assets are sold for cash, purchase of goods for 10,000. So it's your quantity is 10,000. Qualitative aspect is related to any depreciation. This I would explain this next time. Next year's, because this concept you should understand the one another activities or another basic terms. So I'll discuss it briefly after some time. Next, financial in nature. So as we discuss, a business transaction is financial in nature. So every transaction that is done for money or there is an exchange of finance between the two person or more than two person is become your business transaction. Next term I'll discuss with you is on a capital. Capital is a part of money that is invested by the person in the business. Every person who starts a business is invested some amount. For example, I start business with 1 lakh. So this 1 lakh is my capital, the part of money, the part of finance that is invested by person in their business is called capital. Capital may be in cash or in kind. In cash means you should invest the rupees like 1 lakh, 2 lakh, 3 lakh. In kind, you should invest some assets like furniture, like a motor car. So the part of assets like machinery, any machine that you should invested in your business is become capital in kind. So capital, any amount that is invested by the owner, by the proprietor. Proprietor means the person who starts the business. The proprietor in the business is called capital. Capital is increased by profits. If your business earn the profits every year, then your capital would be increased or decreases by losses. If the business has many losses, much losses year by year, then your capital is decreased day by day. So next term is drawing. Drawing means withdraw. If any person withdraw some amount from the capital, it become your drawing. For example, Ram invested 10,000 in business. So 10,000 is capital. After 3 years, he withdrew 5,000 from his business. So the 5,000 becomes its drawing and 10,000 invested in the business is its capital. Drawing is always done for personal or domestic use. If any person withdraws some amount for its personal use or domestic use, for the need of a home, for the need of children or his family, so this terms is known as drawing. The capital, the amount of capital that is withdraw by the person for its personal use or its domestic use is called drawings. Next term I'll discuss with this liability. It's our fourth term. Liability means obligations. Any amount which is owed by one person to another person. Another person is your liability. If, for example, if I purchase something for 1 lakh, so I didn't paid this amount as soon as I done the transaction, I paid this amount after 5 years. For the time period of 5 years, it would become my liability, as I am liable for paying my debt in future or after 5 years. So liability is an obligations to paying the amount to some certain person after some time. For example, Ram take loan for 5 lakh. So loan is also a liability of a person because loan is paid after 5 years or after some time. So for this period of time, it become your liability. You are liable to be paid this amount after the after completing this particular time. So liabilities has further two types: non-current liability or current liability. Non-current liability is also known as fixed liability, liability for more than 1 year. Means if there is a liability for more than 1 year, suppose for 2 years, 3 years, 5 years, so it's your non-current liability or it's fixed in nature. For example, long-term loan. For example, loan is taken for 10 years, so for 10 years it should become your liability. Current liability, liability related to 1 year, means there is a liability which is related for 3 months, 6 months, 9 months, within the one current year, those current year is occurring, current liability is related to that particular year. For example, short term loans or any amount pending or paying to a person, like some short type of amount, so it's become your current liability. Then I'll discuss with you next term is assets. Asset is in a property of business. Anything that is helpful for producing goods and services in the business or for making the profits of the business, this is called assets. As a inner home, car, house, machines are our properties or our assets. So in business, it's there are also some types of the assets. Those are helpful for the businessman for making the production and sold the goods to achieving their business objectives. So assets is also has two types: current assets or non-current assets. Current assets, as a name suggests, current, related to particular year. For example, 2009, related to one particular year. Non-current assets, the assets related to more than 1 year. For example, 5 years, 6 years. So those assets are non-current assets. Current asset is basically related to particular year. For example, 2009 is basically 1 year. So cash in hand, the amount of money that is in hands is cash in hand. So it is for a particular year, so it becomes current assets. As soon as possible, when you need the cash, you should use this cash. Cash in bank, cash at bank, any amount that is deposited in your bank account is also your current asset. You should use this asset as soon as you need it. Next is a non-current asset. Non-current assets has two types: tangible, intangible. Anything that can be touched, seen, it's called tangible. Anything which cannot be touched or cannot be seen is intangible assets. So tangible assets is like furniture, because you should see the furniture, you should touch the furniture. Machinery is also called your tangible asset. Tangible asset but non-current asset means the asset which is useful for the business for more than 1 year. As such, any machinery is purchased by business is not only for 1 year. If you purchase if any business man purchase a machinery for 1 lakh, so it should be useful for 3 years. So it become its non-current assets but tangible asset, because machinery can be touched or can be seen. Next, intangible asset, anything which cannot be seen by the businessman or cannot be touched by the businessman, but it's non-current assets. So it is called goodwill. Goodwill is reputation. Reputation of business. If any business house is become reputed by their activities, for example, iPhone, Samsung, so these are the reputed business. So reputation is also plays a vital role in business, because goodwill has also a value. So this reputation cannot be maintained in a one particular year. For maintaining the reputation, there you should take the number of years for hard work of the number of years. Next, the copyright. Any business houses make the copyright of particular items, particular goods, so copyright is taken by the partner. Or trademark. Trademark means as a name registered for the trade. Any business house has registered their trade name. Trade name is registered, like Samsung is registered by the Samsung company. So it's a trademark. No other one can use the name of this company. So trademark is also a more than 1 year asset, but it is intangible in nature. You should cannot see it, cannot touch it. So it's all about for today's class. Next transactions or next basic terms are discussed in next video. Thank you. Have a nice day.